Good morning, I'm Marco Ballarin and I'm here to present you the results of my Quantum Future Academy challenge. First of all, our goal is to bring the system from the ground state to the first excited state, and to do this, we will shake the potential along the x-axis. To quantify our results, we will use the fidelity, which is a measure of how much two quantum states are similar. We will use two different systems, the single particle with this Hamiltonian, where T is the kinetic energy and V the potential, and the Bose-Einstein condensate, where this term is the mean field interaction between bosons. We use the harmonic and the anharmonic potential with this quartic term. We see that the displacement is already taken into account by this term here. The important difference between the two is the energy spacing. The energy level of the harmonic potential are equally spaced, while those of the anharmonic are not. And this is fundamental because if we excite the system with an energy which is the one of this gap, we actually obtain a superposition of all the states, while in the anharmonic potential, we do not. We see immediately that in the single particle case, with the harmonic potential, we do not obtain good results with the fidelity bounded by 0.4. In the anharmonic case, instead, we obtain really good results using this shaking function, which is an exponentially damped sign, where E01 is the energy level difference between the first excited and the ground state. We see we reach up to 0.92 fidelity to a maximum of 1. It is more interesting the Bose-Einstein condensate case, and first of all, we define the hypothesis, which are the temperature is almost zero, all particles must be in the same state, and the bosons must be weakly interacting within each other, and this is really important, we will see in the following. Here we present a plot of the maximum fidelity with respect to the interaction strength beta, and we see that in the harmonic case, we are not able to reach good results. Instead, in the anharmonic case, we want to analyze the difference between using an optimized shaking function, the one described above, and a non-optimized one, which is this one. We see that the results are really different in this graph of fidelity with respect of interaction strength. And we can also focus on three different zones, the intermediate zone where the interaction strength is not high, the negative zone, which is the attractive part with a high negative interaction strength, and the repulsive zone with a high positive interaction strength. The first one, where the interaction strength is not too high, has optimal fidelity. Here we can see the probability density function with respect to time, and the maximum fidelity is reached in this zone here, where the probability density is localized in two different spaces. And this is important because the first excited state has an odd parity, and so must be localized in two parts. This plot is for beta equal 1. Then we can see the strongly repulsive zone, and we can see that the fidelity remains almost constant for some value of beta and then drops, where the Bose-Einstein condensate approximation is no longer valid because the interaction is too strong. We see here the graph for a beta equal 20 of the probability density, and we lost the oscillating behavior due to the strength of the interaction. At the end, we'll see the strongly attractive zone, and we see that as soon as we move away from zero, the fidelity drops. This is because, as we can see here, the probability density is really more localized than in the other case, and so the state is not able to change the parity from the even parity of the ground state to the odd parity of the first excited. Here, the beta is minus 10 for this plot. So we can conclude that the harmonic potential is not suitable for this type of control, but the anharmonic one is really okay. And that beta, the interaction strength, is really important for this analysis. We want to conclude with some ideas for further studying in this subject to optimize the results. And a possible way is to use the GRAPE algorithm present in the composer, and another one is to use a reinforcement learning approach. So using genetic algorithm called NIT that starting from a simple neural networks builds the minimal solution to our problem, such that given as a rewards function, the fidelity is able to minimize it. So I thank you all for your attention. I've finished.